Good evening, everybody. I want to thank you for tuning in to another episode of Real Talk with Joe Collins. Special shout outs to the CRN Digital Talk Radio Network. You guys are awesome. You've always been awesome to me, and I really appreciate that. So one thing I want to talk about, you know, and I'm gonna be on the show by myself. I want to talk about the reason that the mainstream, I guess the popular Republican message does not work in the inner cities and why Republicans are losing in the inner cities. So with that being said, I mean, we can talk about the history of the Republican Party, and then we can talk about the modern times when it comes to the Republican Party and why the messaging don't work. And that doesn't, I don't really think that it's the messaging. I think it's the people behind the message that isn't working. So when we look at the history of the Republican Party, we have to, you know, understand that the Republican Party was started to help Black people become free from slavery, from indentured servitude, and involuntary servitude. And the majority of the Black people who got involved in politics, whether it's the U.S. House of Representatives or the Senate, were Black. There were no Black people in the Democratic Party, because the Democratic Party fought to keep slavery going. As a matter of fact, the Democratic Party started because they wanted to keep slavery going. And I don't think this is a concept that a lot of people understand, especially a lot of Black people. And so when I hear Black people say you're coon or all type of dumb stuff, because I'm a Republican, you got to think that, you know, you join the same party that fought to keep slavery. You join a party that created laws that are so disgusting. Laws that have destroyed Black people's family, Black people's communities, everything about Black life. The Democratic Party has been created to destroy that. I mean, we can go back to the 1820s. You know, they had laws put in place that if slaves got away and the owners didn't go find the slaves, the owners will be tossed in jail and fined. A lot of people always try to tell me that, oh, there was this switch in the parties. There were a switch in this, there's a switch in that. And I don't even know why Black people are so nice. They're so nice, like, oh, no, there is, everything has changed. Everything is different. Didn't anything change? And let me tell you something. If the Democratic Party actually cared about Black people, Black communities, Latinos, Latin communities, then everything that they've done to us from the 1800s all the way up until now, they would have created some type of restitution for us. But they didn't. They wanted to keep us enslaved. They wanted us to stay on the fields. They didn't want us to have freedoms. They had advertising that they put up throughout different cities and different states that depicted Black people as monkeys. Stupid, ignorant monkeys. And I take extreme offense to that. It's ridiculous. But we're going to dive into some history today. And I want you guys to stay tuned, because it's going to be a pretty interesting conversation. I think a lot of people are going to be upset. Stay tuned. We'll be back.
If Ernest Hemingway was alive today, would he say this to you?
Shakespeare, Mark Twain, Edgar Allan Poe, all great writers. And after reading your book, I simply must add you to the list.
Wait, you don't have a book yet. So make a free call to Page Publishing. Their expert staff can help you turn your book idea into a real book, a masterpiece that could someday make the bestseller list in hard copy and digitally all across the world. Page Publishing can help you completely take your idea for a book, write it, and publish it. So if you want to join the ranks of some of the most famous authors in the world, call now for a free information kit. Turn your book idea into publishing gold. Make a free call right now to Page Publishing.
800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. That's 800-378-3212.
Hurt me so many times, and I forgave you. But this time, I love.
I just want to listen to the music for a second because it sounds good. But anyways, getting back to it. The Ku Klux Klan was started by the Democratic Party back in the 1800s. And it is not a secret. This is not a secret that these things happen. And they had action plans that would help Democrats continue to win elections in different states because black people were then voting Republican. They were Republican because nobody wanted to be a part of the party that was created to destroy black people if you are a black person. So when I hear black people tell me like, oh, no, they switched, that the Democratic Party isn't like that and all of this and all this BS, when it's still proven that the Democratic Party is like that. I mean, Nancy Pelosi want to erase every single piece of racist history in America, but they won't get rid of the racist history of the Democratic Party, which means you have to get rid of the Democratic Party. So they fought to keep us enslaved. People talk about a switch because, you know, there was a president who signed the Civil Rights Act and he was a Democrat. So all of a sudden that gave everybody the impression that the Democratic Party favored black people. And that's the most false narrative ever. Because if you go back and you look at the history, that Civil Rights Bill was only passed because every single Republican was on board with it. It wasn't passed because every single Democrat was on board with it. Hell, if the Democrats was on board with the Civil Rights Bill, then they would 100% agree with having that bill signed, but they didn't. It was less than 40% of the Democrats that were in office at that time signed on to that bill. Just because the president who put it into law, who bottom-lined it, was a Democrat, does not mean the Democratic Party somehow switched. So my thing is, even when we're talking about the Democratic Party, even if they did switch, I mean, come on, hypothetically speaking, I'll play your game, right? How come they haven't given any restitution to black people and black communities? They love us so much, right? I mean, like, look at Joe Biden, for example. Joe Biden passed with the help of Bill Clinton, who, you know, God willing, he goes to jail soon for raping them little kids. With the help of this man, passed the most heinous bill that targeted people in inner cities. The crime bill. The crime bill incentivized mass incarceration for black and brown people in urban areas. They have bills that economically disadvantaged communities like South LA, the one I'm running in right now. They have done absolutely nothing to give back. They've done nothing to right the wrongs. Nothing. So any black person that tells me, I understand you're a Democrat out of heritage, whether you're a moderate or you're far left, or you just agree with this whole entire platform. But think of this. Name something that the Democratic Party has done to help black people and black communities, because I can name thousands of things that they've done to destroy black families and black communities. And I ask people that question all the time, and the answer is still the same. They always say, well, the Republican Party didn't do anything. On the contrary, my friend. But I'm a Republican because of the history of the Republican Party. I'm not a Republican to be a part of any boys club, to be a part of their, you know, their grand scheme, to be on the inside. For me, it's purely about the history of the Republican Party and the values of the Republican Party. That is what brings me to the Republican Party. And I think that's the same thing that brings a lot of people to the Republican Party. The reason why the Republicans are losing in the inner cities is because, for one, they're non-existent. They've allowed Democrats to run urban areas for a very long time. And so people only know the Democratic Party. And then when you do get people who are Republican coming into the inner cities, they want to shove a message down the people in the inner city's throats as if their personal ideology or their personal ideas of what the Republican Party is fits anybody who lives here in the inner cities. And I think that when people do this, what you tell me is you have no respect for how people in inner cities feel. You have no respect for how Latinos feel. You have no respect for how Black people feel. You have no respect for how, you know, white people who live in urban areas feel. Because why should we subscribe to a message of a party that is non-existent in our communities? Why? It sounds great. The president did this and the president did that, but the president is not coming to the inner cities. Yes, he have Black people go to the White House. Yes, he has Latinos go to the White House, but he has never stepped foot in South LA. I don't know any prominent Republican who has stepped foot in South LA. I don't know any prominent Republican who has stepped foot in Chicago, Detroit. Flint still doesn't have good water. New York. Dense Democratic areas, but yet everybody want to win in these areas, but they don't want to step foot in it. So now you got a guy like me who's running for Congress against Waters in South LA. We kicking our ass in fundraising. We kicking our ass and being popular in the district. But because I don't subscribe to the mainstream Republican message shoving that crap down people's throats, I don't get the support that I need. My support comes from the people. And I read the comments on Facebook. I read the comments on Instagram and people, you got paid to do this. You got paid to do that. First of all, I'm retired from the military, right? Nobody pays me to do nothing. We raised $3.14 million in this race. $2 million the last 3 months. Yeah, we had our problems at the beginning of our race. We ironed those problems out and we moving methodically. And we are killing it. But I don't want to preach that mainstream Republican message that everybody is talking about in the inner cities because it does not fit. One thing that we used to talk about in the military is that you have to take care of home first. If you don't take care of home, then you cannot be focused on the mission. So everybody want to focus on the mission without taking care of the people at home. What do you mean by that, Joe? Well, we live in a dilapidated community. We have a lot of gangs in our communities. We have a lot of drugs in our communities. We have distrust between our communities and the law enforcement. We don't have opportunities. We don't have economic opportunities in the inner cities. But we're supposed to preach this message that everybody wants us to preach as if there is a handbook on how to be a Republican, a winning handbook on how to be a Republican that we're supposed to go by to get people to turn from Democrat to Republican. When we have people who can't take care of their bills, we have people who can't take care of their children. We have people who are out of work. And everybody's quick to say, you guys have the same opportunities as everybody else. That's BS. Because there are no opportunities in the inner cities. We have some of the worst schools. We have some of the most expensive housing. We have some of the sorriest jobs in America in inner cities. We don't have manufacturing plants in here anymore. We don't have, tech here. We have aviation. And a lot of people don't even subscribe to aviation community, even though this is a community that we're working with to create quality jobs. So as a Black person, as a Black Republican, why do I need to subscribe to the message that these people are pushing? And what in the entire hell makes them think that this message is going to work on the inner city? And we're going to continue to talk about that. Because I'm blown. My mind is blown. But we're going to take a break. We're going to take a break. And then we're going to come back and talk about why this message is not working. And we also need to talk about why people in the Republican Party are not being influences in the inner cities if we have all of these ideas. Stay tuned. We'll be back.
Let's talk about your credit cards. When you first start using them, it's a slow drip. You make charges, then more charges, then bills come, and they keep coming. When you open your statements, the floodgates come pouring in. You realize you have more credit card debt than you can afford, and you're barely making the minimum payments. Wouldn't it be nice to make one affordable payment and have all your credit card bills covered? Make this free call and learn our responsible way to get your credit card bills paid and under control.
Sponsored by Consumer Education Services, a nonprofit organization.
800-876-3643. 800-876-3643. 800-876-3643. That's 800-876-3643.
CESI is not a loan company. The establishment of a debt management plan may adversely affect your credit rating. Non-payment of debt may lead creditors to increase finance and other charges to undertake collection activity, including liquidation.
Imagine this is your money and someone wants to take it from you. Who is it? The IRS. They want your money, and guess what? They can legally take it, all of it if they want. Remember, they sent you that letter that said, hey, you owe us a bunch of cash and we're going to take it from you. So what do? Fight back by letting our team of experts at the Tax Helpline work it out with the IRS so you can keep your money. And we're good at what we do. When you hire us, you get a team of guys on your side that know the IRS laws and will fight to save your money. So if you owe the IRS a ton of cash and you want to keep it, call right now and learn for free how we can help you put it back in your pocket.
800-932-1597. 800-932-1597. 800-932-1597. That's 800-932-1597.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
All right, you guys, let's get back into it. So I have social media, and I hear everybody else's comments. I see everybody else's comments. I mean, you know what's crazy? There are a lot of people who think that they can talk behind your back and you're not gonna know. And I'll call some of these people out, but I don't want to give them no fame. You know what I'm saying? But they make their Facebook posts, they make their Instagram posts, and they dog black Republicans who are running in inner cities as if they know how to run a race in the inner cities. And my thing is, I've never seen any of these people in the inner cities. Never, never. And we're out here all the time. You know, we've made it so that Republicans can come to the inner city, especially in South LA, and feel 100% comfortable knowing that people understand that we're going to have their backs. Right? So they make comments because, yes, I'm a black man and being black is important to me. And when people see me, I want people to recognize the fact that I am a black man running for Congress in an inner city that I'm from, a city that I'm from, born and raised. I grew up down the street from my office. I want people to understand that I am a black man that is a Republican that does support the president in the inner cities. And we are making headway on winning this race. I mean, we're going to win. But why is it that I have to preach this message that people who've never been to the inner city preaches? How come I have to listen and I have to agree with people messaging for the inner cities when they have never been here before? And then people are like, oh, well, you have an issue with Candace Owens. So what? And I don't have an issue with Candace. I don't even follow Candace. I don't even know this broad. My issue was not with Candace. My issue is with what she said about people who are murdered by white people and cops who are from the inner cities who have a police background, a criminal history. That's what you want to call it. After she just made a lot of money by talking about how policies of the Democratic Party destroyed black families, black communities. So these are not, in my opinion, criminals, especially when they're trying to get their life together. These are victims of those policies. That was my issue. And if she felt so strong about it, instead of teaming up with a bona fide criminal to try and bash me or do her best to try and make me look bad, what she should have did was accept my invitation to come to the inner cities and preach that message and see how people from the inner cities feel about it. Because if I got to have a principal tell me, oh, is this how you feel? Is this how Black Republicans feel about Black people who have criminal records trying to get their life together? Telling me these things? Then I already know we're going to have a problem. And I don't, this is America, first off. I don't have to like anybody. I don't have to like you if I don't want to. I don't have to transcribe to the same message being a Republican if I don't want to. I fought in the military. I served overseas. I did a boots on the ground deployment in 2008 to Iraq. I fought for the right to do whatever the hell I want to. And I'm going to say this again. This is America. Hell, I got to listen to somebody who's never served in the military for? Why I got to listen to somebody who has never had to fight for anything in their entire life? Why do I have to agree with somebody on a Republican platform message? That's not even a message of the Republican platform. It's an individual ideology. Why do I have to subscribe to that just because I'm a Republican and there are other Black Republicans? Nobody has been to the inner cities except for Larry Elder. That's why, I mean, I listen to him all the time. And I've spoken to him a few times too. And I have a lot of respect for him. Because he doesn't back down from any challenge. He's been preaching the same thing for a very long time. He's been active in the community, whether people like him or not. That's why you never hear me say anything bad about Larry Elder. I mean, the guy's message is on point. It's right. We have to pick ourselves up. We have to utilize every single opportunity that we have to be successful. The only problem that I have with that is we have so many Democrats that have been running our city for a very long time that has failed to provide the economic advantage that we need, economic opportunities that we need, improved education that we need for us to be able to pick ourselves up. I've been all over Fox and all these different networks, TV shows, talking about businesses have been failing since COVID-19. Man, Black businesses have been failing way before COVID-19. COVID-19 was just the eye God shined on our communities that shined a light on what's been going on for a very long time. This ain't because of COVID-19. This is from sorry-ass legislators like Maxine Waters, like Adam Schiff, like Nancy Pelosi, like this crappy Governor Gavin Newsom that we have, whose sole purpose is to put money in their pockets while leaving everybody behind. I wouldn't have a problem with Maxine Waters if everybody in our community was thriving, if she was getting her money. But the fact of the matter is we're poor. We've been poor for a long time, and I'm sick of people being in our communities being poor. I'm sick of our educations being poor. I'm sick of our housing being poor. I'm sick of the jobs being poor. I'm sick of Maxine Waters is a poor person, and we're going to get into that as soon as we get back. I'm about to take a break. Stay tuned. It's getting real.
This is the Entertainment Answer. The new political comedy Irresistible is a bipartisan look at how silly and out of hand elections can get. It stars Steve Carell and Chris Cooper, and Carell said this about the script.
It's really not so much about the politics themselves. It doesn't necessarily lean right or left. It's really mostly about the people who are caught in between.
Irresistible is rated R for language and available on demand starting June 26th. Remember to be safe and smart out there. For this Entertainment Answer, I'm Matt Mungle.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Hill Street Cafe Burbank would like to thank all of you for your continued support. During these difficult times, Hill Street Cafe is remaining open for takeout and delivery service from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. They'll be offering a modified menu to keep prices down and maintain the best quality. The safety of their customers and employees is their top priority, and they're abiding by all CDC and health department regulations. Order via their Hill Street Cafe Chow Now app or on their website, Hill Street Cafe. online.com. You have the option of a curbside pickup. We will bring the food out to your car. You are also able to order for delivery or pickup via the normal food delivery apps like Grubhub, Postmates, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Hill Street Cafe is here to serve you. Call them at 818-845-0046 or come by to pick up at 3301 North Glen Oaks Boulevard in Burbank, California. Hill Street Cafe, Burbank. Pickup and delivery services are available at 818-845-0046. Or visit them at hillstreetcafeonline.com.
Hi, I'm Dennis Bono. Join me every Saturday at 6 p.m. and Sunday at 3 p.m. for the Dennis Bono Show live from the entertainment capital of the world, Las Vegas. Enjoy this fun-filled hour with my celebrity friends as they perform, visit, and have lots of fun with me in front of a live audience in the showroom at the South Point Hotel. Please join me Saturday, 6 p.m. Pacific, Sunday, 3 p.m. Pacific, right here on CRN Radio and CRNTalk.com.
It's totally normal to be constipated with belly pain, straining, and bloating again and again.
No way.
Maybe it's occasional constipation.
Maybe it's not.
You could have a chronic condition called irritable bowel syndrome with constipation, or IBS-C. Linzess, or linaclotide, is a prescription that treats IBS-C in adults. Linzess works differently than laxatives to help relieve belly pain and let you have more frequent and complete bowel movements. Individual results may vary. Do not give to children less than 6, and it should not be given to children 6 to less than 18. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stools. The most common side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas, stomach area pain, and swelling. Maybe it's not occasional constipation. Learn more at linzess.com or call 1-800-LINZESS. You may be able to talk to a doctor online. Visit linzess.com, sponsored by Allergan and Ironwood.
So everybody, I just want you to know I'm drinking coffee out of this cup, and it's not Starbucks. But if you go to thecollinsstore.org, you can be able to buy all your Joe Collins for Congress merchandise. This stuff, it's some really good quality stuff. Really good quality stuff. But back to what I was saying, COVID-19 is not what destroyed businesses. Our poor legislators is what destroys businesses, because one thing that every single business that business in the inner cities have is that they're small businesses. And so they have no financial literacy. A lot of businesses don't have any financial literacy. I mean, like, we didn't even get the PPP that was rolled out, but you have major universities getting, you know, millions of dollars in this paycheck protection program, or these business grants and loans to keep their businesses open. Now, I don't know why a school with a $42 million endowment needs extra money, but they were able to get it. Meanwhile, you know, we're suffering here in California. And a lot of people don't think that. And it's not even that I think Democrats are the problem. Yes, they have a serious racist history, and I would never be a Democrat because of the racist history of the Democratic Party. And what I mean by history, I mean everything from 30 seconds ago and back, all the way to the 1800s, right? That's the history, because we're in the present now. But that's like, and I give people this analogy all the time. The reason why I would never be a Democrat, because I grew up in a Democratic household, is because for me, you know, you got a history of being racist as hell. I mean, you guys killed black people on a regular basis. I remember I used to get in trouble in the military. I used to try to talk to me when I was in the military about posting history. Everybody want to post about 9/11. They want to post about Christopher Columbus, but they want to forget that, you know, you have white Democrats hanging black people from trees and shooting black people and taking pictures with them for a very long time, as if this history is going to go away. It's never going to go away. Racism was built into the very fabric of America. So was immigration. So this is a history that we have to live with on a regular basis. And I would never, ever be a Democrat again, because that's like, you know, would you date somebody who have AIDS? Absolutely not. Well, if that person, you know, 100 years later, 20 years later, came back and said, hey, I don't have AIDS anymore, would you want to date me? 10 times out of 10, the answer is still going to be hell no. Just because the idea that you used to have it. So the idea that the Democratic Party killed black people for fun, created legislation that targets black people, created legislation that targets minorities, Joe Biden, right? Created legislation that incentivized mass incarceration, Bill Clinton. The idea is still there. So just because you give an apology doesn't make me feel no better about what you did in the past to my people. So I would never be a Democrat, because the idea is still there. And if the idea was there before and this is what you did and history repeats itself, you're going to do it again. And that's exactly what they've been doing. Only this time, they're not hanging black people and murdering black people in the streets, literally. It's called paper genocide. They get you wrapped up in all these laws and contracts and everything. And if you don't follow the laws, and they throw you in jail, they want you to sign these contracts, and we're going to give you all these benefits and privileges. And then in return, they take away your rights. The game didn't change. The only thing that's changed is the way the game is played. And if you don't believe me, go back and look at the history. I don't give a damn how many times Joe Biden get on TV and apologize for that crime bill. He never did anything to repeal it, so he can't be that sorry. I don't care how many times the Democratic Party talking about, oh, well, we like black people. I can't tell, because you guys just never gave any restitution for the things that you did in the 1980s. The KKK is still here. Those laws that were put in place, the redlining laws, those things are still here. Crime bill still here. Three strikes law still here. Crack law still here. You took jobs out the inner cities and put crack in the inner cities. Only thing Maxine Waters was able to do was to get the CIA to admit that they did it. But she never did anything about it. Nobody cares about no damn apologies. What we want is to right the wrongs, even if it means getting rid of the Democratic Party. Now, back to the Republicans. The reason why the Republicans are losing in inner cities is because they don't understand what's going on in the inner cities. And the way I know this is because I'm a black Republican from the inner cities. And I see that they don't understand. I went to Minneapolis after George Floyd died, and I see people comments, oh, he's Black Lives Matter. Idiot, I'm not a Black Lives Matter. I don't care about the organization Black Lives Matter. And I say this all the time. But if Black Lives Matter in my community, guess what? As a leader, I need to get in front of Black Lives Matter, find out what's going on, hear the people, sit in the middle, and come up with a resolution to fix this problem. But no, people don't want to do that. They want to talk trash about Joe Collins. Joe Collins, who's winning in his race. Joe Collins, who's polling at 69%. Joe Collins, who's raised $3 million. You want to sit and talk about me as if you have the playbook on how to win. Meanwhile, I don't see none of these cowards out there. Oh, you want to go to your safe space and you want to protest, reopen California with everybody who already agrees with the same stuff that you agree with. Stand up and go to your conventions and preach the same message in front of people who are already going to agree with you. But when the last time you got in front of a rally? I shut an entire rally down in downtown LA because we were working with the police officers to find some resolve. That's why you don't see California burning like you see all these other states burning. We're not having it. And if we see Antifa and all these people who have infiltrated the Black Lives Matter movement coming back, trying to do anything other than rally, you start destroying our buildings, I promise you. I'm getting gang members, and we're coming down there, and we're beating you down because we don't want our cities destroyed. We don't want that at all. And the reason why I said gang members is because I know I'm not going to find too many Republicans who's going to stand with me in front of Antifa. All y'all going to do is get on Facebook and Twitter and make posts and comments and talk about what Republicans do and don't do. Republicans don't go out and protest, and you were with Black Lives Matter. First of all, that was my protest that we put together. So you guys want to talk about Major for being out there, Major Williams? You want to talk about Robert Foster for being out there? You want to talk about Angela Stanton King? People who are actually out there making a difference. You want to talk about us, but where are you at? On your computer? And we're going to talk about that. We definitely going to talk. We're going to get right into it. We're about to take a break. Stay tuned.
Here's important new information from the Diabetes Solution Center for you, a family member, or a loved one suffering with diabetes. If you have lost your provider, or if you need a provider for diabetic supplies, you may qualify to receive your diabetic testing supplies now with little or no out-of-pocket cost, regardless of your age. All you need is Medicare or private insurance to be potentially eligible. Call the Diabetes Solution Center right now for details. Just takes a couple of minutes. Our friendly, knowledgeable agents will give you free, no-obligation information, handle all the insurance paperwork, and make sure your supplies are delivered directly to your door for free.
Call U.S. Medical Supply 24 hours a day. 888-912-1332. 888-912-1332. 888-912-1332. Call right now. 888-912-1332.
How would you like to save up to $500 on your next vacation package? Any vacation package anywhere in the world. Just call Superior Travel and mention the code RADIO and save up to $500. We'll design a custom, fantastic vacation just for you with all the bells and whistles. Not some cookie-cutter vacation, but a unique, all-included vacation customized by one of our exclusive travel experts. And our service is completely free. You pay nothing more. So why waste your time? Let us do it for you. We've got over 100 years of travel experience to help create the perfect trip for you. Call now and learn how to save up to $500 on your next custom vacation. Pick up the phone, call Superior Travel, and use the code word RADIO.
800-570-9631. 800-570-9631. That's 800-570-9631.
So people want to be upset at us for getting out in front of these rallies. But this is what leadership is about. Leadership is not sitting at home and talking trash about what's going on in our communities without doing anything. If you're going to talk trash, get out there and get involved. Find out the reason why these people are destroying things. And then try to help come to a resolution. When we went to Minneapolis, we didn't just go to Minneapolis and talk to the people. We went to Minneapolis and we told them that we lived in the 92 riots. That was our community. That was our home that was being destroyed. You don't have to destroy your community in order to get things done, in order to get your point across. That was our message. Where are the leaders? Where are the leaders? The leaders who create these laws, the leaders who is allowing these things to go down in your different communities. Right. We always want to talk about first thing. Oh, he's a Democrat. He's a Republican. He's this. He's that. But the leaders are not coming out to these cities. This is why it doesn't matter who I get on. I'll get on Maxine Waters just as quick as I'll get on Kevin McCarthy. Because leadership is important and leadership is what we don't have in our communities right now. I haven't seen Maxine Waters get out anywhere, but I also haven't seen any other Republican so-called leaders get out and get in front of these crowds either. Tell them to go home. Tell them that we're working on a solution. Doesn't matter if you don't like the mayor. If the mayor is the person he had to work with to get things done, work with that guy. Doesn't matter if you don't like the police. If the police are the people who you need to work with to get things done, work with them. But trying to criminalize people who are standing up and being leaders is the last thing that you need to do. Period. And this is why Republicans are losing. Because instead of getting out here and helping, you talk trash. You don't want to support the person who is killing it in their race. Black people tell me that Republicans are paying me to run this race. I'm getting my money from you know, President Trump. I'm tap dancing and cooning and doing all of this stuff. White Republicans tell me that, oh, Republicans don't do these type of things and all of this stuff. My question is, if there are so many Republicans who know how to win a race, who knows how to run a race in South Los Angeles, then why has Maxine Waters been here for over 30 years? That's my question. If anybody want to make a comment and tell me why, I would appreciate that. But from my understanding, all of you guys are rookies. Nobody knows anything. I have Democrats on my team. I have Republicans on my team. I have Libertarians on my team. I have Independents on my team. Because one thing that I understand that a lot of people don't understand is that when you are running for Congress, you want to be a representative. You're not just representing Republicans. You're representing everybody in that district. Democrats, Republicans, Independents, people who like you, people who hate you, everybody. You are their representatives. So as a person who are representing someone, it would behoove you to listen to everybody. Find out why they're in so much pain. Find out the underlying causes. But nobody want to do that. Which is why Republicans lose in inner cities all the time. Nobody comes to the inner cities, yet everybody have the right idea about what inner cities need. So let's try to be more visible and let's try to cut down on the chatter and actually get out here, stop being scared and start helping people who are running these tough races. I don't have any support from anybody except for the American people. I have a lot of support from the people in my communities. I have a lot of support from people across the United States who are donating to my campaign. A lot of people want to see me win, not just because they don't like Maxine Waters, but because they want to see our Black communities thrive. Open Secrets has us labeled as one of the hottest races in 2020 because we raised a ton of money as if I've already been in office. We're working hard as if I've already been in office, but I can't even get the support from the NRCC. I can't even get the RNC to throw support behind my campaign. And mind you, I've donated to all these organizations. I've donated to RNC. I've donated to CAGOP. I donated to LAGOP. But we can't even get any volunteers. I think it's because they're scared of Maxine Waters. But everybody want to talk tough. Everybody want to talk about, oh, I would have did this. I would have did that. You wouldn't have did a damn thing. Because if you would have, you'd have done it the past 30 years she's been in office. Why do I have to get out the military to come back and fix my city? As a Republican, when we have so many Republican geniuses that could have been doing this for a long time since you guys got all the answers. Why does me, as a Republican, have to get out the military and bridge the gap between the people and the Republican Party in order to make something happen when this party has been here for a very long time? In California, I got a lot of protagonists talking trash, and I love it too. Keep my name in your mouth because you're not hurting me. You're only making us better. You're making us stronger. Everything that everyone has said about me running in this race from, oh, he's a plant from the Democrat Party. He's a plant from this. No, this is my community. I grew up on 104th in Normandy. The next major street over from where my office is where I grew up at. My grandfather used to have a church in this community. A lot of pastors came up under my grandfather in this community. I used to run these streets. I had my first fight down the street from where my office is at the McDonald's. I had my second fight right across the street from where I had my first fight from. I'm not a plant. I don't care how many times people say I change parties. This is America. I change parties if I want to. But I'm a Republican, and this is where I want to be at. Not because somebody's paying me, not because somebody's doing something, but because this is a choice that I decided to make. This is where I belong, and I feel like your political party preference is your choice. But we're about to take a break. Stay tuned.
Hello, this is Chef Ava, superfood mom and healthy food educator. It is my passion and joy to share with you all I have learned as a professional chef over the years. Come visit me in the virtual kitchen as we live stream together. My online live stream class experience is where you'll be able to ask me direct questions and receive answers as I share new recipes and techniques. To register and stay current on what cooking classes I'm offering, visit my bio on Instagram at ABA5TAR and click on my link tree to see the current schedule and how to register. Tap on the Chef's Feed live stream button and sign up for my very next class. That's ABA5TAR on my Instagram page under Linktree. Once again, to register for my live stream online cooking classes you can take from the convenience of your home, visit ABA5TAR on Instagram and click my Linktree. Keep cooking and I'll see you in the kitchen.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Attention Italian food lovers. Angelo's and Vinci's Ristorante in Fullerton, California is open for takeout with wine. Can you believe it? Angelo's and Vinci's Takeout is now able to offer you a nice bottle of wine to enjoy with your meal. Order today and get one half price on our special selection of Pinot Grigio, Chianti, Chardonnay, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Merlot. Mamma Mia! Order today at Angelo's and Vinci's from our complete award-winning menu and get some great wine for one half price. We hope you're healthy and safe. We want to keep you well-fed. Wapo's To-Go Kitchen is open from 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. every day, or you can order through DoorDash. Pizza dough, bread, sauces still being made fresh every day. Angelo's and Vinci's named Best Italian Restaurant on the Orange County Hot List. Call 714-879-4022. Angelo's and Vinci's, 550 North Harbor in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4022. That's 714-879-4022.
I think that one of the worst things that we can do as people is disassociate ourselves from others who have a problem. When I think about, you know, the Black Lives Matter and how the movement was infiltrated by people who are destroying different communities, and the reason why I know it was infiltrated because I've seen it firsthand. And I know a lot of people like to say Black Lives Matter is yada yada yada, and they want to get mad at Black Lives Matter. But let me tell you, those are white kids that are out there destroying stuff. White privileged kids with Republican parents, unfortunately. So, I mean, as much as people hate it, I mean, as much as people don't want to admit it, that's what it is. But to disassociate ourselves from an apparent pain, a feeling that someone has, and the only way they know how to show their feelings is through destroying things, says a lot about who a lot of people are as a person. To ignore them and to disassociate ourselves, to make these people feel like, you know, they're less than anyone else because their voices is not being heard, makes us, in my opinion, a terrible person. To bash somebody because you don't agree with their opinion, to ridicule someone because they don't subscribe to your ideology, that makes you a terrible person. And I say that with pure impunity. It makes you a terrible person. And the reason why is because it shows that you fail to take time to study and understand what people are going through. You think that everybody is supposed to agree with you, and it's not true. They don't have to. They don't have to agree with you. They don't have to like you. They don't have to do what you say. They don't have to do things the way you feel things need to be done. They say the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over again, expecting a different result. And that's absolutely true. So if the way you've been voting in politics has been the same for a very long time and you think something is supposed to change, you're insane. If you've been a one-way Republican for a very long time and you think things are supposed to change, then you are insane. If you live in an inner city and your inner city has been ran by Democrats for a very long time and you think something is supposed to change, then you're insane. Life is about balance. The yin and the yang, not just the yin and not just the yang. If you put too much salt on food, then your food becomes salty. If you put too much pepper on your food, then your food becomes disgusting. You have to have balance. You need the same amount of Democrats as you need Republicans. Life is all about balance. And if you don't believe me, try standing up on one leg and see how long that's going to last. Sit in a chair with three legs. We have to have balance. That's what life is about. So I appreciate the support that we've been getting from across the United States on our race. And I know that everyone is not going to agree with everything that I say or everything that I do. But everything that I do and say is for a reason. And whether we get support from the NRCC, the CAGOP, the RNC, LAGOP or not, I'm still going to be a Republican. I'm still going to be running in this race, and we're still going to win. Because I come from the U.S. military, who has a tradition of winning and never losing. That's the ideology that I subscribe to. I subscribe to a winning ideology. An ideology where they used to say, you come from the inner cities, you make it to 25, and you make it, then you're golden. That's me. I'm a Cali boy from South Central Los Angeles. I'll see you guys next week.
Enjoying all your favorite CRN programming is easier than ever. It's